to God, who's my Heavenly Father and author and finisher of my faith, and to Dr. Davis, my pastor, and to you, my Mount Zion family. I greet you with the joy of Jesus in my heart, for truly He is the joy of my salvation. I thank God for each and every one of you. Don't see you as often as I'd like, but I'm out doing the ministry that the Lord has called me to do. And I thank you for your continued prayers as I continue forth in the ministry. I want to say good morning to my brother and sister in the ministry, Brother McCray and his beautiful wife, Sharon. Brother McCray and I have shared years at Washington Baptist Theological Seminary, and I just thank you all for being here, for your support. Lest we tarry, our scripture has been read, and it's found in Philippians, the 3rd chapter, verse 12 through 14. King James translations records it as thus, as Paul has written it. Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend, that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. Amen. For those of us who prefer a more straightforward understanding of this text, I've taken the liberty to actually pull it from the Message Bible, and it's recorded this way. I'm not saying that I have this all together, that I have it made, but I am well on my way reaching out for Christ, who has so wondrously reached out for me. Friends, don't get me wrong, but by no means do I count myself an expert in all of this. But I've got my eye on the goal, where God is beckoning us onward to Jesus. I'm off and running, and I'm not turning back. How plain and simple is that? My subject for this morning is, don't look back. You're not going that way. Focus on your goal and keep moving forward. The Message Bible summarizes this text with a subtitle that just simply says, focused on the goal. Determination and focus are two essential needs to reach the highest goals. In this text, Paul tells us that in order to grow as Christians, we must be focused and determined. When I think about looking backwards, I'm reminded of, as a child, some things my parents used to say to me. When I became distracted by something or someone and my focus was immediately taken off of what was at hand, these instances would cause me to turn around and look backwards. And I'm sure we've done that as a child, we still do it now. Something behind us distracts us and causes us to turn around. The phrases that were used then, I even carried it over into my parenthood. And some of the things that were said would be, turn around. Keep your eyes in front of you. Stop looking back. Or focus and pay attention. Those phrases would always cause you to what? Yes. Turn back around and look forward. But what was so important that I had to keep turning around? Was it curiosity, or was there something more interesting behind me than what was in front of me? We've entered a new year of 2017, a year of new beginnings, a year of new goals, and a year of new commitments. However, there are still some distractions from 2016 that may interfere with our focus and determination for this new year. These distractions may cause us to look back and hinder us from moving forward. Could it be that We are not ready to let go of the past. Could it be that we want to cling to traditions? Could it be that we're afraid of change? Could it be that we're so comfortable, we have a comfort zone, that we don't want to leave that comfort zone? There are many reasons where we don't want to let go of the past. But Paul tells us that if we want to be focused on our growth, we must forget the past. Obviously, Paul is not telling us to literally not remember anything, because there are some things we should remember and carry on with us, such as remembering who we were before we accepted Christ in our lives. We should remember the times we've seen God's faithfulness demonstrated to us in our lives. Amen? Amen. We need to also remember the mistakes that we've made so that we can avoid them in the future. Remembering that our past experiences are our testimonies to those who may not have any hope. Paul is not telling us that we don't have to fulfill the responsibilities of the past either. If we've wronged someone, then we should put forth every effort to try and make it right. Amen. Just because it's 2017 doesn't mean that, okay, I've done something wrong to that person. Oh, well, it is what it is. Oh, no, not in God's sight. Amen? Not in God's sight. If we had an ought against someone, we didn't do it before 12 this morning, you need to find a way to go reconcile with that person. However, when Paul talks about forgetting, he's telling us that we cannot and we must not live in the past. What happened in the past is past, and we must keep going forward. Don't look back. That's not the way. There are two reasons we need to forget the past. First, we have a tendency to fixate on the past. Let me explain. We will hold on to some bad experience, and it will become an anchor that weighs us down. We will remember a hurt that someone inflicted, and it will eat us up. I can attest to that and be a witness to that. We will remember a time when we stumbled, and then we will determine that we'll never try again. How we deal with the painful time of the past will determine how we live in the present. We must learn from the pain and then move on. Yes. What God has forgiven should never be taken as a burden. Amen. Second, we have a tendency to rest on the past. We will replay the past victories and be content to remember instead of continuing to push ahead. Paul determines that he would not rest on past accomplishments but always look forward to what yet needed to be done. So now the question arises, how do I focus on my goal for 2017? What do I need to do to keep moving forward? Well, I have three points that I would like to leave with you this morning. First, we must realize that God has a goal for our life. Paul says in verse 12, not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend, that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. In other words, he said, I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. Paul understood that the Lord took hold of his life with a goal in mind. And this is true for all of us. God wants us to be conformed to the likeness of his son Jesus. Amen? God's desire is that we grow to be like Jesus. It is important to realize that God's goal is not just to get us in the door. He's not looking merely just to save us. He's working to transform us. As Christians, we are moving to be Christ-like. That's what being a Christian is, to be like Christ. It is also important to realize that God has a job for us to do. We are a part of his plan. God does have a plan for each and every one of us. His plan will lead us to joy, fulfillment, contentment, and eternal blessings.
Yes,
what shall our goal be for 2017? It should be the same goal that Paul had when he wrote this text. His goal was to know Christ, to be Christ-like, and to be all Christ had in mind for him.
Yes,
that should also be our goal.
Amen.
We should not let anything take our eyes off of our goal,
right,
which is to know Christ.
Amen.
We must lay aside everything harmful and forsake anything that may distract us from being effective Christians.
Amen.
What's holding you back?
Great.
What is your distraction? Don't look back. That's not the right direction. You're not going in the right way.
Yeah.
We need to press and move forward. 2016 has come and has gone.
Yeah.
Today is the first day of a brand new year.
Yeah.
Be determined and stay focused.
Oh, yeah.
Let me give you the second point. We must recognize that we have not arrived yet.
Yeah.
We have not arrived yet.
All right.
As it is clearly stated in the Message Bible, Paul says, I'm not saying that I have this all together.
All
That's
right.
what Paul said. That I have made it, but I am well on my way, and by no means do I count myself an expert in all of this, but I've got my eye on the goal. Paul not only recognizes that the Lord has a grand purpose for his life, but he realizes that he has not arrived at that purpose yet. I've realized I haven't arrived yet either. And how many of us know when we've met some persons who feel like they give that air like, I'm there? God is not pleased with that. It's not about this physical body. It's not about you, but it's about giving glory and praise to God. Amen? It's about giving glory and praise to God. Paul knows he is not what he should be. He's aware of his faults and the areas where he still needs to grow. The word perfect also means complete.
Alrighty.
Paul recognizes that he is not finished yet. God seeks progress, not perfection. Some of us get discouraged because we feel that we're not progressing very rapidly. This Christian life is a life of growth and maturity, much like life itself. Growth takes time. As diligently as Paul worked at his faith, he still had not arrived. Just as Paul persevered in his walk, we must also do the same. So I say to you, don't look back into your past. Don't be discouraged. Keep moving forward. Be determined and stay focused. And my last and final point, keep your eye on the prize. Keep your eye on the prize. Paul tells us in verse 14 to press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. In other words, he is saying, I've got my eye on the goal. Where God is beckoning us onward to Jesus. I'm off and running, and I'm not turning back. Paul tells us that he must always keep his eyes on the prize. So now, what is the prize that should encourage us to go forward? Well, what image should we keep in the forefront of our minds? I'm a visual person, so I want you to come on and let me paint some pictures for you. What is that prize? Why should we be striving for that prize? What is it? Well, how about this? The image of standing before the Father to hear him say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Having your life reviewed without any sense of regret or shame. Picture yourself with him right now. Being surrounded by those whose lives have been redeemed partially because of your faithful witness. Having someone say you were consistent and faithful as they deliver your eulogy. The joy of that first moment when you see Jesus. Have you even thought about that? You know, we say, oh, when the skyscraper, I can't go down on my knees. Well, what about when you first see him? What's going to happen then? Have you even thought about what your reaction would be when you first see Jesus. Think about that. So I say to you again and again and again. Think about this. What's holding you back? What is your distraction? Don't look back. That's not the way to go. Keep pressing and look forward. Focus on your goal and keep moving forward. Set your sights on things that are higher. Press for the prize. Seek to know him better and more fully. Jesus tells us that when we seek ye first the kingdom of God, then the other things that we are concerned about, those things that's in the past that's hindering us from moving forward, those things will be taken care of. He'll take care of those things. But seek God first. Put your faith and trust in God this year, and you'll see that this year will be better than 2016. Be strong and of good courage. Yes. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Keep pressing on and don't give up. It is because of God's unending love that we can be part of God's eternal kingdom. Keep pressing on. Don't turn back. Keep moving forward. Don't turn back. Keep your eyes on the prize. Don't turn back. Focus on your goal and keep moving forward. When you let go and you let God, you'll see that the rest of this year will be more meaningful to you than the year before. And then when we get to the end of 2017, we're going to say the same thing because we've got to keep our eyes on that prize. We are on a mission. Amen? We are on a mission. As Christ-like, as Christians, as believers in Christ, we've got to set that example for persons who don't have any hope. None whatsoever. That's why some of that past you hold on to. Because your past can be a help to someone's future. Testimonies. That's what testimonies is all about. Being able to help somebody else who's in that same position where you can truthfully say to them, been there, done that. Let me tell you how you can get through it. Amen? Keep pressing forward. Focus and keep your eye on the prize. God bless you.
Amen.